I think we're in a good place with the cabin now. It's still about 10 days before opening day of firearm season. And we got all the stickers on, or bantams as some people call them. And everything pretty much in place. We have to put hinges on the door on the other end, but we got all the stickers here on this side. And up there, we got all these cut off. Some are short, some are long, but that's kind of my character, up and down, you know. But anyway, we got, you know, pretty much sealed up as far as boards and slats and bantams and stickers and so forth. And anyway, we have some more to do to it. We have to fine-tune a few places. We're going to put the insulation, cans of insulation where you just spray it on all of the corners and any hole that's sticking through, you know, where we can see light. Like, for instance, these doors here were used with light wood and probably dry when we used them, and now you can see through them a little bit. We might put stickers on them or bantams. But Dolores came up with that. I thought that was pretty good. That's a vine right there. And she drilled a hole in it and put it up there. And you can grab a hold of it for old people, you know. And it'll just pull right up. It's pretty solid. But, if it wasn't for me and the boss building it, it wouldn't be all that special. And it wouldn't be all that good. But here, let me show you the inside. We'll have the boss open the door for me.
I have some floor work to do.
You have some floor work to do? Okay. Yeah, that's right. We had one bad board back here. And she, the boss built that door right there. And she built that door there, too. We don't have a lot of sunlight in here yet, but you can kind of see that there's a few. You can see through the corners just a little. That's where we'll be putting the insulation stuff. And then we have one board to put up there on top in that corner where it comes together. It's 7 foot on this end and 8 foot on this end, and then it's 18 foot long. So we ought to have room enough for a lot of shells to shoot a lot of deer. I hope it doesn't take, you know, 20 shells for one deer, but generally it only takes us one, but that's on a good day. Anyway, we thank you for watching, and we especially want to thank RustyGloveBox. Hey, boss, I see one sticker that we forgot. We thought we had them all done.
Well, that's because we have to fix this handle.
Oh, you're going to have to. So you're just going to wait to take that? Okay.
Take it off.
Yeah. See, I blew the. I cried wolf or something here too soon.
We put the sticker on first and then put the handle.
Aha, I got you. Okay, okay.
Yep.
Okay, so we're pretty much got her here. And it's rough, but hey, we're rough. The wood's rough, you know, and we'll seal her up. I got a little gas stove out of an RV that runs off 12 volt. A little, you know, with a blower and everything. Or I have a little wood stove. And I'm not sure I want to fool with a wood stove in this timber and so forth. But it would work, don't get me wrong. And it would be more, it would fit in more. Same style, class, whatever you want to call it. But anyway, we're like the one woman in the Bible that the scripture says, she hath done what she could. So that's exactly what we did with, it wasn't used lumber. The outside bantams, or the stickers as we call them, were actually, they were pallets, weren't they, or something?
Crates.
And our son had a bunch of them, and he gave us some plexiglass there, and put those big windows in. That was pretty easy. We just cut everything back, and then it fit flat, and we'll put a little sealer on those. But anyway, thank you for watching. Thanks for all the notes from Rusty Glove Box and anyone else that's been watching. Thank you. We appreciate your watching. Bye-bye.